Everyone, and welcome back on my channel. For those who missed last week's episode, I created a partnership with the Tourist Board of Emilia, Gal del Ducato and Food Valley, which organized this enchanting tour. But right now, I'm on a minibus ready to discover Valtrebbia. Today's stop is going to be the Castello di Rivalta, an impressive fortified complex in the province of Piacenza.
The first stop of our tour is the Castello di Rivalta, where we are going.
Inside the castle's complex, you can find a church, a spa, two restaurants, a cafe, an hotel, a shop, several museums and a tour operator. Curious as I am, I even went watching how a suite looks like. So that if you might would like to bring your beloved one here for a weekend during which you will make her feel like a princess, your princess, you already know where to book for the night. Don't thank me! Just enjoy the beauty of this place and share the video with your contacts. The place is really pretty, but today is but scorching and we are so thirsty and hungry that the great organizers of our tour planned for us a nice aperitivo in the bistro of the castle. Nothing better to start this tour. The wine you see comes from the vineyards of the Count. Right, because you have to know that the owners of this place are the Count Zanardi Landi, who still live here. Inside the tower, you can buy some local products, such as marmalades, cured meat, and also the same wine you maybe sipped at the bistro. But now, let's start our discovery. Walking around the park is a relaxing and refreshing experience. Our walk is accompanied by the sound of the many little birds which are on the trees.
It's so hot, but we are lucky because it's a sunny day, so we can enjoy this walk around the park of the castle.
Right behind these trees we start seeing a tower and the main central building of the complex. We go inside it. Thank you. The main hall is pretty big, and it shows the importance of the family through its coat of arms painted on the wall next to the entrance, but also through the several others which are all around the room. These are those of the many noble families who got related with the Zanardi Landi through the centuries thanks to marriages. The room which I liked most is the next one, the dining room. Isn't it pretty?
We are now in the dining room, as you can see, but I want to tell you something pretty cool, actually. Here, the family was used to have lunch. Over there, behind that door, there was the kitchen. And maids were used to bring food, passing it through this little door on this table. The food could have been served with no problems and pretty fast. Another cool thing is that all the dishes, you can see them, are kind of different. For every single food there was a particular dish with a peculiar design. So every meal had a special design. As long as I told you about it, now I bring you to the kitchen, where you will be amazed by the quantity of nice copper pans. What was cooked and served on the table came from the cellar, which in the past times was used as the stable and recently as a discotheque for private parties. Yes, because you can rent the castle for private events. But now, let's go to the upper floors. One interesting part of the castle is the area dedicated to music and chit-chats. Along the corridor there are several doors, which bring to different small rooms. In the past, inside every room, different topics were treated. So, when guests reached the castle, they knew where to go, if they preferred to talk about something specific. A little bit as clubhouse during our days. Coming inside one bedroom, we see a pretty short bed, and we learn that our ancestors were used to sleep being seated. Why? First of all, because whereas they were used to eat a huge amount of food for dinner, this position could help them during the digestion. Secondly,
because they thought that only dead bodies had to lie down. One of the nicest things the castle has to offer is the view over the valley. For this reason, we go up inside the tower. I must admit, I feel a little bit as if I were Rapunzel. Talking about princesses,
did you know that in this castle, Princess Margaret of Windsor was used to come here for her holiday the last week of August? Do you want to see her bedroom when she was staying here? Let's go!
As every self-respecting castle, also this one apparently has a ghost. And it is said that Princess Margaret felt its presence. The legend says it is the ghost of the cook Giuseppe, who got killed in the 18th century by the butler because he violated his wife.
From the castle and from my friend, it's all. See you.
Wait a minute. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon, because next Monday a new episode will be out. See you in Brugnello. Ciao.